I don't think fear should be a place to motivate us, but because we're human and we see what we see and we hear what we hear and we witness. I mean, Daniel Pearl being beheaded, the Washington Post journalist still in Iranian jail in Iran. I mean, when you see Jews and Christians being kidnapped and beheaded, like they have no value for human life, if more people were to be as outraged and in the condemnation, maybe Americans would begin to believe that you're just outraged by the loss of human life and this kind of horrific, these crimes that we see.
There is a distinction between Islam and radical Islam.
Listen, for those, there are those of us, they embrace, the issue is, yes, there is a distinction, but that the Muslim community should do more of condemnation as well as the media.
Rula?
I don't know where this person is living, but
modern Muslims, he said, Muslims are not condemning Muslim extremism.
I don't know where he's living. I don't know what television he's watching, but he is in total denial. Not only that, he's talking about crimes committed in Iran, in Saudi Arabia.
Right.
What does Muslims in America have to do with that? Why they need to be criminalized because of that? Would we ever accept a presidential candidate that would apply the same rules, would say the same things about Jews and black? We would never tolerate them, would never respect them, would never expect, even accept them. We will shun them aside, but we accept it against Muslims because sadly, in the Republican base, this is what is appealing to them today. And not only
Mercedes.
That, what happened, just finish this, please, because it's very important. Happened with Trump, we are discussing the first part of what was said and Trump endorsed, which is we have a problem called Muslims, but there's a second part, how to get rid of them. And in the realm of possibility, in a country that is very armed, that somebody that will be carrying weapon will go to a mosque tomorrow or after tomorrow and will start shooting people. And then these people will have blood on their hands, all of them.
I've got to go, guys. We certainly don't want that to happen, but interesting.
But it might happen.
A lot of people were offended by his remarks, but I have
dialogue.
To say this.
That's what we need.
I have to say that his campaign has raised $600,000 to $700,000. They've raised $20 million in the last quarter. $600,000 to $700,000 just after his Muslim comment.
That's a Republican base.
You can raise some money from an intense minority, but over the long term, that's not going to wear well, even in a Republican primary.
We got to go. Thank you, Rula. And Mercedes and Ryan, you're going to stay with me. We'll be right back.